today goes back to Russia's relationship with the United States. And so I'll ask you just a couple of questions about that, and we can move on. The U.S. says you personally ordered the 2016 interference in the elections. I know you deny that. You have said you wanted Trump elected. What do you want to see in 2018 from these midterm elections?
Do you mean in Russia or in the U.S.? About what are you asking?
In the 2018 midterm elections in the United States.
I will be serious in this issue. I want all this nonsense to stop. The nonsense that has to do with some fantasy meddling of the Russian Federation with some election campaigns in the U.S. so that finally the elites of the U.S. would come down, would figure out what they want from each other, and they would be able to restore balance, just like in the oil markets, the balance between common sense and the national interests, I mean, so that the domestic feuds within the U.S. would not poison the Russian-U.S. relations and have a negative impact in the world.
I'll ask this final question on the political front. In Helsinki, you said that you wanted President Trump to win because he favors better relations with Russia. But in fact, as Russia itself says all of the time, relations between Russia and the United States seem to get worse every day. Wouldn't it be better for Russia to have a president in the United States that is not politically compromised by the widely held perception that this country helped him get into the White House?
First of all, I do not think that President Trump was somehow compromised. He was elected, people voted for him, that was the choice of the people. Someone might not want to respect the opinion of the electors and voters in the U.S., but it's not our business, it's the business of the U.S. What's better, what's worse? Politics do not allow for such speculations. It could have been worse, we do not know. We proceed from the situation we have now and are going to work proceeding from that. We do not know whether it's for the good or for the bad, but we do not have any other president, and we do not have any other country instead of the U.S. It is a major world power, a leader in many fields, our natural partner in a whole spectrum of tracks, including international security, non-proliferation of weapons of mass destruction, combating terrorism, combating climate change, protecting environment, and so on. We have a lot of overlapping joint challenges and problems, and we should solve them together. We proceed from the fact that sooner or later, the time comes when we will be able to restore the relations 100%.
In this conversation,